Last time on Corpse Party.
What the fuck are these? Ah! They will cause death. Oh no!
Okay, it's all you. I'll be waiting right here. Yeah, they're gonna get separated now.
Morishige?
Why are you running? Mine's, Yuya Kizami. I've also been separated from my little sister. If you'd like, you may accompany me. We'll look for your big brother along the way. I guess it was those children. Ho! Doesn't matter if you're killed by them or killed by me.
Was I knocked out?
Yuka? Yuka, are you there?
Greetings, my beautiful viewers! I am the Hunter of Comedy! Welcome back to Corpse Party! I have many feelings about the last episode. I am literally picking this up immediately after, the last episode, because I could not stop, because something I have to mention, so okay. Hold on, so, last time, Satoshi and Yuka found the expanding hallway that led to the second building. We went to the second building where they were separated because Satoshi is a fucking idiot and decided he would leave his sister alone to use the bathroom when in a horror situation. You don't do that. You become piss buddies. That's just how it works. Anyway, we met this seemingly really cool guy named Yuya Kizami who promised Yuka he was gonna help her find her brother because he was also looking for his little sister. And so, you go around. He unsealed the protected door, possibly letting out whatever was inside, sent Yuka inside to use the bathroom, and then his friend showed up, and he Spartan kicked his friend, like, you know, after stabbing him. Future Brandon, show a clip of that really quick.
This is Sparta!
Yeah! Yeah, that's what happened! Holy fuckballs! So yeah, now we're playing as Satoshi, who has woken up in some kind of science lab, and nothing is okay. I don't know, I was surprisingly calm last episode. I think I was just processing. But nothing is okay now. Nothing is okay. I don't know where I am.
That looks bad. There's a plaque inside the case commemorating the school's establishment. Why are there bloody handprints all over it?
Covered in bloody handprints, as if someone was fanatically caressing it. Oh, that's bad.
Haphazardly crammed to bursting with crumpled up documents. Newspaper clippings and scrap paper. School scandals continue. Principal questioned in liability.
I'm starting to think maybe the principal had something to do with this. Like, if I remember properly, like I said, I played, like, the later games. I'm pretty sure he had something to do with it, but I'm not sure what his part in all of this was. I just don't know, because they don't really talk about it much in the future games.
A cursed school, the many grisly happenings at Heavenly Host. School nurse reported missing. Oh, lots of bad things happening here. Is that the victim's memoirs number 5?
Well, we have to get that bad ending, and gonna do that temp save again just to make sure in case I was stupid and I forgot.
Oh, no, I want to read it. No. Let's see what happens here. Looks like I'll be dying soon, so I'm going to try and keep my finger steady just this one last time. The bleeding never stopped, and it's getting colder and colder. I can barely see. In the end, we never did find one another. Unless you magically pop out of the shadows real soon, we never will. Mitsuhara, I've always idolized you. You constantly surpassed me in every way, always one step ahead, no matter what we were doing. I kept telling myself that at some point, I'd turn a corner and you'd be there. But I knew better. My brain knew better. My brain rejected that notion from the beginning. If I should dream in death, though, then I know I'm going to see you when I turn this corner. like I've been praying for all this time. We can beat up each other like we used to. And I'll never have to be alone again.
Oh, God, my head!
A wave of nausea and unbearable despair suddenly washed over Satoshi's entire body. Next thing he knew, he was standing in the corner of an extremely narrow red room. His movements weren't his own. It was as if his mind was disconnected from his body, with no perception of surface or gravity or motion. After a sudden dip jarred his senses, he realized he was moving purely on nerve impulses with no direction or control. Perhaps he'd been taken in by the curse, by the wave of negativity that permeated this space, far beyond the spectrum of human understanding. His shell of a body might as well have been a twig skipping across the ground in a windstorm. Without warning, his very sense of self had been completely destroyed, leaving him in a virtually lobotomized state. Seeing the remnants of a man's tortured soul are indeed a thing best left untouched. For this dying message, and the curse it carried, certainly had no trouble at all dismantling the essence of what was once a boy named Satoshi. Well, that was kind of a lackluster one. The other ones were a lot more interesting than that. Okay, I can't get to that corpse back there to get its name tag. I don't know where I'm supposed to go here. Oh, there's a note. Heavenly Host Bulletin. An individual unaffiliated with the school broke into the building last night and killed himself. This is the third such incident. The deceased was a 72-year-old single male from a neighboring prefecture. Weird. Strange but true. Stories of the occult. Chasing down the hidden paths of the cursed school building. It really exists. By Ko Kibiki. Give it a look? Eh, sure, why not? Over the course of several days, a series of incidents occurred within this town in which young children disappeared one after another. Their whereabouts were ultimately discovered through a thorough police investigation, but said findings were very much a worst-case scenario. Oh joy! Three of the missing children were found dead in a concealed room beneath Heavenly Host Elementary, officially unused throughout the school's history. The fourth missing child was thankfully still alive, quaking in fear on the ground, presumably only moments away from demise when police arrived. Capping off this nightmarish scene was an adult male member of the school's teaching staff who seemed to be in a state of confusion. In his hands were a pair of bloodied scissors, 1973-918. The surviving elementary school student, after psychological counseling, gave official testimony fingering the Scissor Man as abductor and murderer. Staff member in question was officially charged with multiple counts of abduction and murder of minors, as well as desecration of the dead. Boy, he was quickly taken to trial where an insanity plea spared him from prison or death, but resulted in his compulsory admittance to a mental hospital. Interestingly, the perpetrator of these crimes was none other than the school principal's own son, was widely renowned for his jovial personality. However, due to a mental ailment of unknown origin, he'd begun losing his ability to speak little by little during his years teaching at Heavenly Host. Once his speech was all but gone, he began searching for alternate places of employment, which occupied him for several months prior to the crime. The results of this endeavor were not favorable, however, and most of his days were spent staggering idly through the streets. His reputation quickly degraded, as it would. Several months after his admittance to the mental hospital, he managed to slip past the many nurses on duty and escape the premises. Immediately upon doing so, he made his way into the concealed basement room at Heavenly Host Elementary, where he took his own life by hanging. Oh my god. The three children he had killed were all Heavenly Host Elementary students. But the one girl who was rescued from the gaping maw of eternal slumber was not. Sachiko. Following her close call, she and her family moved to another prefecture, far from the memories that no doubt would have otherwise haunted them forever. Sadly, this was only the beginning of the misfortune that would hereafter plague the school, which had already earned itself many an unsettling rumor. Over the next few years, Heavenly Host would become a stage for countless incidents of rape, molestation, and suicide. Oh my god! With student resignation and attendance dwindling at the alarming rate in response to these crimes, the school was eventually shut down. 1975-1118. The 60-year-old principal at the time, who had become infamous as an eccentric, who adorned his walls, doors, and furniture with incomprehensible graffiti. Even later, forensic analysis of the writing throughout his office could make little sense of his haphazard scribbled enumerations. And the day after the school's closure date was finalized, the aged eccentric threw himself from its roof. Broke his neck on impact, dying instantly. As you can clearly discern, the sordid history of this school is indeed awful, but there may be more to it than merely a series of unfortunate incidents. Power greater than any of us can comprehend may be acting as puppeteer from the shadows, maintaining an actual tangible curse upon this property. And the key to it lies with the sole survivor, the girl who bore witness to the brutal murders and mutilations of three children no older than she. The girl in the red dress, the one who got away. My investigation into the supernatural side of this horrific massacre is only just beginning. Rest assured, I intend to make this a regular feature. I've begun gathering data for a follow-up report, so stay tuned. The next issue promises to uncover more details in this morbidly fascinating story.
According to this article, one girl survived the murders. But if this photograph is correct, then it's the same girl in the red dress we saw earlier.
Yeah. My guess is that the thing about her moving away was just a cover story. She may have survived the incident, but was killed later on, and maybe that's why. I'm not certain.
Why was someone who wasn't killed here be haunting the school?
That is a very good question. There's a bloodstained cassette on the floor. It seems to be from a digital video camera. Pick it up? Sure, why not? Colored mini DV tape. The label reads Kibiki Research Data, 2005-11-19. Is there somewhere I can look at this?
Damn, looks like I'm locked in. To worry so much for another's well-being that it torments you to the core. It's an exquisite stigmata that afflicts the living and the dead alike.
And you are? Ugh, our eyes are so cloudy, like a dead fish.
I'm the spirit of a girl who died here.
Okay. I'm really not sure how to respond to that.
Happiness and unhappiness are linked. Whenever one attempts to gain good fortune with little effort, there's always a risk.
What are you trying to say?
You and your friends have become trapped in this school because you performed the Sachiko Ever After charm and messed it up.
I don't know, here's the thing. Did we mess it up? I'm not sure if that's really what the problem is.
Sachiko, you mean that paper doll thing we all did? How did we mess it up? One of you chanted the phrase too many times, or too few. The number of participants determines the number of repetitions that must be spoken. And somebody goofed.
God, that expression on her face, dear God.
Everybody said it 9 times? Machiko, we beg of you, 9 times.
All right. Pretty sure it wasn't me. I remember saying it 9 times.
Someone else mess it up? Is that why? No.
No. I'm not gonna start placing blame. This wasn't anyone's fault.
It may have been on purpose. One of your friends probably thought the whole thing was silly and didn't even bother to count. Or maybe a misguided member of your group didn't want the fun to end and knowingly flubbed the charm in a vain attempt at prompting a do-over. No. Even if it wasn't on purpose, some of your friends have a tendency not to take things very seriously. No, it's not inconceivable they'd mess up. And just say, oh well, it's not like I'll ever be found out. Without even realizing that their actions would ultimately damn you all. No one's owned up to it, right? Not a single one of your friends has said, I screwed up, I'm so very sorry.
Shut the hell up already!
My apologies. I propose far too many likely scenarios, it seems. Perhaps it's the nature of my job. I have long since abandoned my writings, after all. You do still have your scrap of paper doll, no? Be sure to hang on to that. And hang on tight. Treat it like a memento. A memento of those who are dear to you.
Sorry to cut this short, but I'm in a bit of a hurry here. I seem to have gotten separated from my little sister. And there's still some other people I need to find, too.
Such concern for your friends, and all the impulses that go with it, spurring the heart into action. It's truly a noble sentiment. That's all charms really are, you know. They represent one's regard for other people. They're like microcosms of the soul. Whether it be love or hate, all you need is a truly strong emotion to set them off. The stronger it is, the more powerful the charm. Splendid man's hook.
I'm burning up. Wait, hold on, what are you?
Frigid sui ball.
It's like a body's on fire. Stop this! Please stop!
Ball sui frigid hook man's splend. We will not allow anyone to stand in our way. Those who do will suffer without mercy. Now go. Go to the one who occupies your thoughts. Though you probably won't make it in time.
Continued in chapter 4. Well, fuck. Back to Who You Care For. Chapter 4 has been unlocked. Extra 2 has been unlocked. Okay. Well, now I gotta go through and figure out how to get the bad endings. Wait, I should check to see how many bad endings I missed. Okay, that's the chapter clear ending, the regular ending. Okay, that's the wrong end 2, wrong end 3. Ah, and succumb to the poison and collapse. So I'm only missing one, actually. Yeah, I actually did that off screen because, like, nothing really happens. I guess it is technically a bad ending, but literally it's like, you just die. You just fall down. Yuka's like, Yuka says big brother, and that's the end. So what is ending 2? That's the one I need to find. Okay, so what we have to do to get the bad ending number 2 is decline to take the beads from Yuka. So now we don't have the beads, and that is actually what's going to get us killed. Because remember how I thought it was weird how the little ghost boy down here didn't, like, do anything to us? Yeah, that's because we had the scented beads. It protected us.
Yeah, hi.
Ugh.
He's staring right into my eyes. What? I can't move. Come with me.
Big brother, don't!
My body, my legs, they're moving on their own.
Big brother, stop!
Oh, god damn. Spirit of the little boy stares at you with wide eyes and mouth agape, but he has no tongue. Oof. It was only a few short seconds before the moment Satoshi fell, and the moment he hit the ground. And there was really nothing he could do to prevent it. After all, he had no control as he inched his way toward a certain doom. He certainly had no control once gravity took over. Without even time to gasp in grim realization, he impacted upon the uneven floorboards below and could feel his innards exploding outward. Yet he remained conscious for somewhere between a couple seconds and a minute before his life eventually came to an end. Staring up at the hole in the ceiling, just as his vision began to dim for the final time, he saw his little sister, Yuka, who had jumped in after him. Oh no.
Yeah, that's a pretty bad ending.
Pretty bad ending. I'm surprised I got all but one of the bad endings this time in this chapter. I really am surprised. Alright, I guess we're moving on to chapter 4 then. Do the chapter 4 opening. Yes, we will. I think that we'll probably only be able to get through the opening before we're gonna run out of time for this episode, because that ending took a little while. What the?
Seiko? Come on, you. I'll wash your back. I can wash it myself, you know.
What are you hiding under your hands there, little man? There are no secrets in this bathroom.
Come on, don't.
Mwahaha! Take this and this.
What are you doing?
Come here, you little cutie pie.
Wait, what?
Stop it, sis! That tickles.
Yeah, that, okay, that looks a little uncomfortable.
Gotcha! Why do you have to be like that? You know, sis. Sometimes, you really are like a mom.
You really think so? You're such a sweetie.
That's her little brother that she left behind.
I didn't mean it like that. You've really grown up, you. Always thinking about your big sis's feelings.
Oh, well, maybe I shouldn't have, made that go away. God.
But you're still young, you know? Too young to act like a grown-up. You should stop worrying about me and just keep being a kid. Oh, you're crying. See, you really are still a kid.
What? Seiko was a bit weird.
Want some of Mama's milk? That's not even possible. Don't be a perv.
Yeah, she... Seiko was an odd duck. I'm still sad that she hung herself, though. Oh, my God.
You're such a good kid. Don't ever change, okay? I hope you stay like this forever. Sis is really late getting home today.
She's not coming back, kid. She's not coming back.
And she said Dad had a surprise for us, too. Said she'd help me get ready for it.
Oh, no.
Wonder how much longer she'll be.
Oh! A bird just hit the window!
Man, are we having a typhoon or something? Such weird weather. Mayu? Mayu? What is it, Mom? I'm running late. This is your last day at Kisaragi. Make sure you say your goodbyes and have lots of fun with your friends, okay? I will. I'm so sorry about this. All because your father got transferred. It's okay. I'll be fine. I wish your father would have objected more strongly.
But he said there was nothing he could do about it.
And since you didn't object either, I swear that man doesn't give this family any consideration. All he thinks about is work. Uh-huh. Well, I gotta run. Bye!
I just want my mom and dad to get along. Oh my God. What? Hold on, we saw Mayu get splattered, what the hell?
Huh? Where am I? Why am I by myself? And why am I crying? Shig? Bro? You there? Miss Yui? Shinozaki? I was just in the classroom with everybody taking down the festival decorations. God, what even is this? Where? What? No. No, please. No, no, no. No, 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 no. Stop it. Stop it, Mayu. Don't succumb to panic. Take a deep breath. Try and think of a charm or something to get you through this. That's it. Shinozaki's charm, the one we all did. She said we'd be friends forever. Wait, it's gone? It's gone! I can't find it anywhere. My Sachiko ever after paper scrapped. Gone! I was so sad to think that my time with everyone was over, but I had it in my hand. I know I did. This sucks. What happened after that?
I'm starting to notice a trend. People who lose their scraps of the Sachiko Ever After charm seem to be the ones who are dying.
Oh, that was her stomach? My God, that sounded like something worse!
My stomach is in bad shape, too. Why does stress always give me indigestion?
Oh, joy!
What were they? They went in that room. Maybe I should take a look.
No, Mayu, no! We know what happened after that! Chapter 4. Oh my God. Ugh. Head, where am I? Ugh.
I'm in the main building.
Wake up from a bad dream and find myself in another. Damn it! I still have the bloody audio tape. That's, you know, good to know. Okay.
All right, I'll officially save here. Whew.
Big brother!
Yuka!
Oh my god. It's still bad.
Mochida, this way. Please take care of Naomi. She's on the verge of snapping.
I think that's Seiko! Who's there? Who's speaking to me? I swear that sounded like...
Yeah, I think it was. I think that was, the minute hate all your friends.
We're in the space, the same space that Naomi is! Naomi! Hey, are you alright? What? Naomi?
Isn't that Naomi's cell phone? Yeah, I'll answer the phone, why not? Got nothing to lose.
Help me. Help me.
Naomi, are you there? Answer me, please! Naomi, please just let me hear your voice. Please say something. I'm your mom, Naomi! Please don't let anything happen to her.
Hello? Hello?
Help me. Help me. Help me.
Screams of woe came from Naomi's phone. Ugh.
What the hell? This place needs to cut the crap already. I can't just leave it, though.
Used this to text with Seiko during class. Seems like a distant memory now. Oh boy. Oh, whoa, it is dark here. Ah, shiitake. I can barely see anything. Okay, I'm examining everything because I want to try and find her.
Well, it was tough, you know?
Oh, no. I tripped on something. That was weird.
Certainly was surprised.
Mm-hmm.
So, Seiko, did you hear? What is it? What is it? Kishinuma bumped into Sasashi turning around earlier and totally touched his crotch.
What? Seriously? I like it. I like it. Why would you like that?
I saw it happen, though. I wanted to smack Kishinuma upside the head.
Oh, dear Naomi. Do I detect a hint of jealousy?
Maybe. Maybe not. All I know is right afterwards, the two of them got into a huge fight.
That's priceless. Wish I could have seen it.
I don't think you'd be so keen on it if you were there. It wasn't a pretty sight.
I don't know. I have a feeling I would have enjoyed it anyway.
Boys are such idiots.
Cute, though. Mochida in particular, right, Naomi?
Is someone there?
I am concerned. No indication anyone's inside.
No.
You sense a presence behind the stall.
Kick in the door! Whoa, fuck! Naomi! Dumbass, what the hell are you doing?! No, Naomi! What do I do? Try and hold her up! You can do something to lessen the rope around her neck. Hoist her on my shoulders. Okay, I got this. Hold on. Good. She's breathing. Naomi, stay with me. I'm gonna loosen the rope. Stand on bucketed feet. Reach behind to unfasten. Let's try that. Can't see what I'm doing. Is this it? While still supporting Naomi on his shoulders, with her upper body drooping between the back wall of the bathroom and his head, as he reached behind him and filled with the knots at the base of the rope, somehow or another, he managed to loosen the rope's grip. Oh! I did it! Oh my god. Naomi. Hey, you alright? You're alright now. Breathe! That's it. Easy now. Just like that. Breathe in and breathe out. Slow and steady.
Satoshi?
Yeah, it's me. You alright? Really had me scared there for a minute. What's wrong? Are you in pain?
Dumbass! Get here sooner next time!
Oh my god! I saved her! Oh my god! We saved her! Naomi! Oh my god! And it was Seiko. Seiko was like, you gotta get to her fast! And we're like, we're on it! What?
Sorry! What's wrong with me? What am I doing?
Hell, no need to apologize. There's no need. Huh? No need to apologize.
Oh!
Is your neck okay?
My neck? What was I doing anyway? I fell down the stairs and then... when I came to, you were here.
You don't remember anything?
I guess not, after I fell. I heard a snap in my leg and figured I'd broken it. Turned out it was just the splint that Seiko had used on my sprained ankle earlier.
Oh, well, lucky you! Shinohara, I think I heard her voice a bit ago. Any idea where she went? Oh, no.
Seiko is...
oh, she was in the stall right next door.
No. That's impossible. I heard her voice. She spoke to me just a few minutes ago. Seiko!
Let's get her down. I'd feel bad leaving her like that.
We had a fight just before we parted ways. I was the one in the wrong, but I was too stubborn to admit it. And next time I saw her, Seiko was already dead. It might have even been my fault. I said some pretty mean things to her. And I can't even apologize anymore.
Naomi, it's all right. It's not your fault. You do realize that you also tried to hang yourself, right?
I... did? That's not possible. But there is a stinging pain around my entire neck. Did I really?
So you don't remember? I'm sure it was the same for Shinohara. I don't think she knew what she was doing. No matter how upset she was, she would never. She wasn't the type to give up on anything, much less kill herself over it.
You're right. She wouldn't do that.
Probably not, anyway.
Actually, there was this spirit who came to talk to me. A girl about the same age as us. She said that anyone who'd been touched by the curse of the school will have their mind taken over and go crazy.
Their mind taken over?
Curse or no curse, I do get the feeling that anyone trapped in here long enough would go insane. Clearly, we need to get out of this school as soon as we possibly can. The longer we're here, the more danger we're in. Even if Naomi and Shinohara, two of the strongest people I know, could wind up like this, then any one of us could be next. Myself included. We better make sure nobody's left by themselves in here anymore. It sounds like we need to hurry and find the others. And let's get out of here.
Yeah. That brings up something else, though. That girl spirit also said this school was its own version of a closed space. And that Seiko and I were the only living beings present. So how did you get here, Satoshi?
Not to mention it. This was a different feeling in the air. There is a different feeling in the air now than there was before. Such concern for your friends, and all the impulses that go with it, spurring the heart into action, is truly a noble sentiment. I think that was the ghost from the first time.
Now go. Go to the one who occupies your thoughts.
Probably won't make it in time. That's what she meant. Come to think of it, I was also approached by the spirit of a high school girl. Shortly afterward, I lost consciousness and woke up not far from here. Wonder who she was.
I'm not sure, but sounds like you somehow made the leap from one close space to another.
Close space? The first ghost we saw said that if two people were in different spaces, it would be nearly impossible for them to meet.
Ah.
Huh?
It's nothing. Satoshi? I think I heard Yuka's voice on the second floor earlier.
You did? Two of us got separated when I lost consciousness. She can't be by herself in a place like this. She'll never make it. Last I saw her, she was headed out onto the walkway between the two wings. Come on, Naomi. This way.
Okay.
Shinohara, I'm sorry. Wish I could take you with us, but it doesn't seem like that's possible anymore. Please forgive me.
Seiko!
Are you okay? The damage to her neck and throat may have been worse than I imagined. Might have cut off oxygen to her brain or something.
Sorry, I suddenly got really dizzy and tripped over my own feet. Now everything's turning white.
Whoa! Naomi. Looks like she's lost consciousness. Need to take her somewhere to rest. Isn't there a nurse's office somewhere around here? Oh, that's bad! Breathing seems normal. I guess she's okay. Need to find Yuka. Naomi, you stay here and rest up. You just said not to split up! I know it's dangerous for either of us to be by ourselves. But that goes for my little sister, too. I can't just ignore her. I'll be back real soon, I swear. Yeah, he doesn't know how bad it is to be in this room. But, yeah, that is where we're gonna cut it for this episode. Oh my god, so much happened. Holy fuck, but oh my god. We did it. We saved Naomi. Oh boy, oh.
Oh my god, I almost can't believe it. Oh my god.
Yeah, now I'm now starting to think that Naho is just an evil spirit, just like everyone else, who's just trying to destroy as many lives as she can because she's also trapped here. Yeah. God, I hate her. God, I didn't before. Before she was like a mysterious, like, you know, information giver, but now, like, she seems to be like an actual villain, and that's bad for us. But either way, thank you everybody so much for watching. I appreciate you being here with me. Oh boy, next time we're gonna be heading off to find Yuka, leaving Naomi in the nurse's office, which is bad. We know it's bad. Well, we, the player, know it's bad. Satoshi doesn't know it's bad. He is making all the bad choices, but he still saved Naomi, and that's what matters. And now we'll be off to find Yuka next time. So, thanks again, everybody. And as always, if you enjoyed this as much as I did, you know what to do. Like, comment, subscribe if you are not already. Ring that bell for all them notifications is. And until next time, have yourselves a beautiful day, my beautiful, beautiful viewers.